So in module 2 we will look at problem solving. We are going to take up a small problem which is finding the largest of 3 numbers. It is a fairly simple problem, but in this problem by looking at this we will see how we can take a problem, break it down into smaller chunks, we will see how to do a flow chart or at least come up with a sequence with which you can solve this problem, and I will also show the rudiments of how to write a C program and the software environment that is required for it. So, let us jump right into the problem. So, we are looking at largest of 3 integers or 3 numbers. So, let us call them A, B and C. So, this forms the input to the program or input to the problem, and what we are interested in finding out is what is the largest of the 3, is it A, is it B or is it C. So, we have to start somewhere and we have to start with comparisons. So, let us say I compare A and B, I am going to check if A is greater than B or not. There are 2 possibilities, A is actually greater than B or it is not. So, if A is greater than B, then it is still possible that C could be greater than A. So, we go and check if A is greater than C also. If it is yes, then indeed A is the biggest of all. So, you have already checked it against B and you have checked it against C, and therefore A is the largest. However, if this condition is not true, if A is actually less than C, we know that A is greater than B, therefore C must be the greatest of all. So, this A is greater than B, but it is less than C, therefore C is the largest. Now, let us look at this other side. A is greater than B is false, which means B is the largest among A and B. And now, we can also check if B is indeed the largest by comparing it against C. If B is greater than C, if it is true, then B is the largest. Otherwise, C is the largest. So, let us take one look at this problem before we go and write a program for this. We first compared A against B, and if it is true, we checked A against C. If both are true, then A is indeed the largest. If A is not greater than B, then we checked B against C. So, if B is greater than both A and B, C So, if B is greater than A, but if it is less than C, then C is the largest. If B is greater than both A and B, then B is the largest, and so on. So, this is the basic setup that we have. So, at this point of time, it may make sense to try it with a few examples and check if this is indeed correct, if this solution is correct. So, let us take this example, A is 1, B is 2 and C is 3. So, let us check this. Is A greater than B is the first thing that is checked. So, you compare A and B. Is A greater than B? No. Right? A greater than B, the answer is no. Now, you are ready to check is B greater than C, and so to compare B and C, we take B, we take C. Is B greater than C? So, B is not greater than C. So, the answer is again no, and therefore, the result must be C. So, essentially we have taken this path. Let us take another example. A is minus 1, B is 5 and C is 2. So, again if we check A greater than B, it is false, and B greater than C is true, therefore, we would have taken this path, B is indeed the largest. So, with these 2 examples, I am now fairly convinced that this solution is correct. Let us go and write a program for this, and we are going to write a small C program, and in the process I am going to show you what it means to write a program. So, I am going to use this environment or an IDE, also called an integrated development environment, called Dev C++. It is a piece of software that is available for Windows, and it's available for free. It's widely used, lots of downloads. I can provide you links later for how to download it and how to run it. I already have it installed. So let me start a new program. So I'm going to start a new program, and I'm going to call, so I'm going to write a piece of a comment in it saying this is a program to find the largest of three numbers. So I want to be able to take input from the user. I mentioned earlier that we need a library for input and output, and that is going to come from stdio.h, and I am going to write the main program. So do not worry about the mechanics right now. So as I mentioned earlier, main program is the very first instruction that is executed, and to do that, so the body of the main program is enclosed within braces. So I am going to have three integers A, B and C. I am going to prompt the user for the values. So printf is a statement which will print things on the screen. So it will print enter ABC on the screen. At this point of time, we expect the user to actually print these numbers, and there is some scanning that we have to do, or reading from the user, and we do that with this library function called scanf. So don't get scared by the statement that is there. So all it's doing is reading A, B and C. So and you can see that every statement ends with a semicolon. So that is the terminator. And now let's write this program. So we want to be able to compare A against B and A against C and so on. At this point of time, it may make sense to actually go and look at the diagram once. So we first compared A against B, and based on yes or no, we did further comparisons. So let's compare A against B first. If A greater than B, then A still might be, less than C. So we have to check if A is greater than C also, and if it is, then we are going to declare A as the largest. However, if this condition fails, then C is the largest. So again, don't look at the mechanics right now. So just follow the logic. We already had this. Let's go down further. So we have taken care of two cases. We have looked at A greater than B, and we have seen this side. We have taken care of this side. Now we are ready to write code for the right side. If B is, so by this time we already know that B is greater than A. We want to check if B is greater than C also. If B is greater than C, already we know that B is greater than A, therefore B is the largest. Otherwise, C is the largest. So this is actually a complete program. So we have at line 2, so you can see the line numbers on the left side, at you can see it here, so watch the mouse pointer. At line number 2 we have hash include stdio.h, starting at line 4, ending at line 28 is our main program, and the body is from line 6 to 28. There seems to be something which is int a comma b comma c, so it seems to be reading in the values of a, b and c here, and we have some checks and we have some print statements. So this is the whole process. So what we have really done is we have prompted the user for entering a, b and c, we read it from the user and we have written this piece of code which actually declares whether which one of a, b or c is the greatest of the three. So let's save this program. So at this point you are prompted for a name, so I am going to write largest of three numbers. So I am giving a fairly big name to the program, but you may want to give a smaller name if you wish to. So I have this, and this is not going to result in anything. So we just have a program. By looking at the program one can visually check whether things are correct or not, but the proof is in the pudding. We have to make the computer run it, we have to give it test cases and see. So we started with the specification, we have the design which was the diagram that I did earlier, and we have coded now. Now let's go and compile it. To compile it you go to execute compile in dev C++, and voila, we don't have any errors. So I have written a program which has no compilation errors. We are ready to run the program now, so I am going to press F10 for it. When I press F10, the first statement that is there is printf enter a, b and c. So this line number 7 is really not an executable statement, we will see why it is so later. It is actually called a declaration. So we have declared variables a, b and c of a type called int, which stands for integer. So the first executable statement is actually printf. So printf enter a, b and c, and if you see the screen it just shows enter a, b and c. You can see that the double quotation, the open and close quote, is actually missing in the output. So this is the way in which printf, which is a library function, takes an argument. So library functions are just like mathematical functions. So if I ask you what sine of x is, you would write it as sine within parentheses x, would you not? It is the same thing here. So printf is a function, within parentheses you pass the so called parameter to it, and in this case the parameter is the string enter a, b and c, and we can see it on the screen here. So now you can see the blinking cursor here, that means the user is expected to enter something. So let's take the two examples that we gave earlier. So let's go back to the example. We tested 1, 2 and 3 and minus 1, 5 and 2, right. So I am going to enter 1, 2 and 3, I am typing it from the keyboard, and it says C is indeed the largest. So far so good. Let me go back and try another input. To do that I have not really changed the program per se, which means nothing in the logic of the program has changed. I could just use the executable directly. This is what I mentioned earlier, you could write it once, compile it once and run it how many ever times you want. So I am running it the second time without making any edits to the program, because I do not see any evidence that the program is erroneous. So enter a, b and c. So I am going to use minus 1, 5, 2 as an input, and it says b is the largest. So we have tested two cases, this does not mean that it would work for every case. So what I am going to do is I am just going to try and give all possible combinations of starting from, let us say 1, 2, 3, I am going to try these combinations 1, 2, 3, 1, 3, 2, 2, 1, 3, 2, 3, 1, 3, 1, 2 and 3, 2, 1. So I am going to try these four and these two combinations one after the other, and if there is any bug, I can hopefully catch it. So let me give it one option after the other. So I'm going to run it once, 1, 2, 3. So C is the largest, good. Then let me run it once more, 1, 3, 2. B is the largest, good. 2, 1, 3. I'm sorry. So I'm going to try 2, 1, 3. C is the largest. 2, 3, 1. B is the largest. 3, 1, 2. A is the largest. 3, 2, 1. A is the largest. So I gave 6 permutations that can come from ordering 1, 2, and 3, and it looks like this program is actually correct. So this by itself does not show that the program is correct. For the inputs that I have given, it's correct, and in this case it would actually sort any number. So we have also tried it on negative numbers. So let's try all negative numbers. Let's say -1, -2, -3, and in this case A is the largest. So just for fun, let's try, instead of giving numbers, let's try something else. So I'm going to give input as, let's say, S, T, and R. So I gave 3 letters and I didn't give numbers, and it actually says B is the largest. So what happened here? So we gave 3 letters S, T, and R, and it says T is the largest. So for whatever reason, we will see why, how this happened. We will see why the B is declared as the largest. So what is in fact B, what is A, and what is C, we will see in a later module. But as of now, if I give numbers, things seem to work. So just for one last time, I will try another input, 200, 100, and 1000, and C is the largest. So far so good. So this, we started with the problem and we went through a sequence of steps, and we designed a solution to the problem, and the design is here. So this diagram is the design, and once we have the design, we went and coded it, we checked the code by testing it. So we have the whole setup. So let me close this IDE or Dev C++. So with this, we are at the end of this demo. We saw this very first program that we wrote, we tested it, we compiled it, we tested it, and we ran it multiple times to ensure that things work okay.